So in this video, I'm going to explain that things which you can do on Upwork and which you cannot do, because Upwork is having like really like high restrictions on it, on this platform, and you cannot like share more and more details on Upwork. So there are some limitations and there are some restrictions as well, that what you can do on Upwork and what you cannot do on Upwork. So it is very important to know that what exactly you can do on Upwork, because if you do not follow the guidelines, if you do not follow the like the complete instructions on Upwork, then you may lead to suspend your account. So there are like fixed things that you can do on Upwork, and if anybody like go beyond those like limitations, then suspend their profile. So here I'm first going to explain that what you can do on Upwork. So let's start. Any person with any skill set can create his or her profile on Upwork as a freelancer. So any person who is having like any kind of a skill, like a website development skill or iOS development or software development, communication skills, writing skills, or you can say any support type of skills. So she can like create his or her profile on Upwork and like can search for a project. Any freelancer who have already set up his or her profile on Upwork can set up his or her agency profile as well. Upwork give the feature like to all the freelancers who want to like go for an agency page, so they can set up their agency profile over there and can showcase themselves as an agency also. Any freelancer or any agency can search for any project on Upwork. There are like thousands of projects available on Upwork based on your skill set. So you can search any project over there and can bid on that project. Any freelancer agency can communicate with the client on Upwork platform. Upwork is having the functionality of chat, audio calls, video calls, and group discussions. You can add as many members as you want on the group discussion on Upwork. You can schedule the call with the client. You can do Google Meets, Hangouts, and you can do like the real-time chat as well with the client. So Upwork is having the complete messaging section over there. And you can directly message to the client once the client opens the message box with you. You cannot initiate any conversation with the client from your side. Only client can initiate the conversation with you. And once you got the response from the client, after that you can share your views, your messages, your documents, your files with the client in the same message box. After discussing the project with the client, you can start the contract on Upwork. Upwork is having the complete project management type of thing available, and you can set up the milestones and you can set up the dates and everything over there, and you can share the files as well on Upwork. So it is a really good platform to manage your projects as well over there, and you can have the complete the conversation in the message section and the complete project management in the contract section. Once you are done with any milestone on Upwork, or if you complete any project on Upwork, you can accept the payments as well on Upwork, because Upwork is having integrated payment gateway system, and client can send the payment to you on your profile, and you can accept the payment on Upwork. You can add your payment withdrawal methods like your PayPal, like your direct bank transfer, or other wallets as well. So you can directly accept the payment on Upwork, and after that you can transfer it from Upwork to your main account. So it is very easy. Once you are done with any project, after that you can close that contract on Upwork and can ask the client for a good feedback, because that feedback will be visible on your Upwork profile, and other clients can see that feedback and the project as well, that how many jobs you have completed, so you can have the complete list of projects that are done by you on your profile and on your agency profile. And other clients can see that and can try to understand about your expertise and your previous projects. So it will be beneficial for you. Always try to get the positive feedback from the client. Always try to get a very 5-star rating and detailed project related feedback on your profile. It will be beneficial for you. So in this section we will cover that what we should not do on Upwork, because Upwork is having high restrictions, high limitations. So things we should try to avoid, we will discuss in this section. While you are working on Upwork and setting up your the profile over there, so never ever mention your contact details, because the clients will not contact you directly. They will only contact you through Upwork. And also, if you mention your contact details on Upwork, Upwork may suspend your profile. So never ever mention your contact details, neither on your profile nor on your cover letters while bidding on Upwork. Some people mention their contact details, their email address, phone number, or their address, physical address. So never ever try to mention these details on Upwork, because Upwork may suspend your profile. So these are highly restricted things. While you are bidding any project or communicating with any client, so do not use unprofessional language, because Upwork can detect these type of things, any abuse or any unprofessional language. So Upwork can detect that and can suspend your profile. So do not use any unprofessional language. Some clients also raise a concern on Upwork that this freelancer is doing unprofessional behavior with me on Upwork. So that is not acceptable on Upwork, so do not try these type of things. This is my personal opinion, that do not bid on those projects which are not related to your skill set. Let's suppose if you are having a profile in iOS development, then do not bid on Android application projects or website development projects or marketing related projects, because if you have any skill set, then try to build your profile on the same. Try to get as many projects as you can in the same skill set, because it will strengthen your profile and you will get direct invitations on your profile with the same expertise. It happens multiple times, many freelancers complain that they did not get the payment from the client and they worked the complete. So it happens. So my suggestion is, do not work without any live contract. Whenever client asks you to start the contract, then you should also ask him to start the contract on Upwork, because many clients try to do these type of things, that they ask the freelancer to start the work and they will start the contract after seeing some work. So never ever try to as a freelancer do these things. Always ask the client to start the contract on Upwork, and after that start the work. Also, whenever client start the contract, ask him to set up the milestone as well. So do not work on half funded milestone or low, if the milestone cost is $100, so do not start the work if the client only funded $50. Also, always try to start the work once the client fund the complete milestone. It is very recommended, because once the client get the work, after that there may be chances that client will not pay you. So always try to work on the completely funded milestones. Always do your communication on Upwork. Always message the client on Upwork, share the files on Upwork, share the details on Upwork, share the code files on Upwork, and everything on Upwork. Always schedule the calls on Upwork. Do the video call, audio calls only on Upwork, because whenever you have any dispute with the client, Upwork check all the communications, that what communication you had with the client, and see all the work and deliveries over there. It is also recommended that you should like do all your communication on Upwork. So this is also one of the guidelines from Upwork, because in future you may have a dispute with the client, so Upwork will not be responsible for the communication which you have done up outside of Upwork. So these are the very important points which you should keep in your mind while working on this freelancing portal. Important things. If you do not follow these things, then you may lead to suspend your profile. So it is really important that what you can do on Upwork and what you should not do on Upwork. You can do all these things on Upwork, but it may lead to your profile removal or suspending or deactivating your profile. So do not try to do these things, and you can all do these things on Upwork. And Upwork is a very good platform to start your freelancing career, and you should create your profile over there, and you can earn a very handsome amount from there. So always keep in mind these things while working on Upwork, and you will surely get success over there. Thank you.